Hello friends, my name is Anuradha and in this lecture I'll continue with the previous lecture where I introduced fixtures and also the related terms like yield and the scope of fixtures. So in case you do not know what is fixture in Pytest, go ahead with the previous lecture. Now what we will talk about in this lecture is sharing fixture across different test files with the help of conftest.py. And to understand same, I'll be creating two test cases using Selenium, and I'll be doing that for this demo JPytest store. Whatever test cases I have created so far, previous lectures, and also whatever I'll be creating are available on my GitHub repository QA Milestone Academy. I'll be sharing the relevant links in description below. So let's go back to our development environment and create test cases. So before I create test cases, let me install Selenium. You can install Selenium in my virtual environment using pip install Selenium. So once Selenium is installed, let's create one directory first, Selenium test cases. Okay, now I'll create two test files over here. So what test cases I plan to create over here? So as I said, I'll be demoing my test cases on this demo JPytest store. So one test file I'll create for the test cases related to, say for example, dogs category, and the other test file related to fish category. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll go to this primary page, dogs category, and then we'll click on one of the link over here. And similarly in other test file, we can go to fish categories and then we can click one of the link over here. That's all we'll be doing. Our purpose is not here to learn Selenium, so I'll not be digging deep into whether it is eligible test case or whether how we should be doing it in Selenium. So I'll be just meeting the purpose. We'll focus on more how we can use conftest.py to reduce our common code across different test files. So let's create two files over here under test case Selenium test case directory, test underscore dog test cases. Okay, and the other is, let's name it as fish test cases. Okay, what we'll do, we'll create sample scenario test cases over here. So I'll import fixture and mark over here. So I'll define test case over here, define test underscore view product underscore fish, view product list underscore fish. Okay, and one more test case, define view product underscore fish. So I'll create these two test cases here. And as part of first test, launch Chrome from Selenium import WebDriver. Okay, now we also have to download Chrome WebDriver. So make sure you have Chrome WebDriver downloaded, and in case you don't have, you can go to Google and you can say download Chrome driver, and it will take you to the site once you search for it. Now the other thing which you have to notice, your Chrome version. So my Chrome version is 81.0 blah blah 138. So I'll go to relevant link over here for Chrome driver. I have Windows, so I'll download this on my machine and extract the file. Note the path where you extract the file, Chrome driver.exe. So I hope you have Chrome driver.exe in place. Now let's define fixture over here, and let me define it as, say, Chrome underscore browser, for I want to launch Chrome underscore browser with the help of this. And here I'll create driver equal to web driver dot Chrome. Okay, and within Chrome I will pass executable path equal to the location where I have saved my Chrome driver dot exe. What I'll do, I'll return driver with the help of yield, and finally I need to close the browser. And before that, let me also maximize window once I open my browser. So this is my common task which I want to achieve. I'll just make use of this Chrome underscore browser fixture in my test cases. So here I'll say driver is equal to Chrome underscore browser. Yeah, so I'm getting this value from Chrome underscore browser, and then I'm launching my desired URL over here, driver.get, and I've already copied this URL for fish department, fish category. All right, so let me give some sleep over here first. Okay, let's say 5 seconds, and I'll just print for now. Similarly, I want to click on one of the link in fish. So it is, let's take this link and let's create a test case for this. So I'll create again driver equal to Chrome browser over here, and on same I'll say driver dot find underscore element underscore link, let's go by text method, I guess so, and then I'll pass my text over here, let's say dot click. Okay, and similarly then I'll give some time dot sleep here just to validate and see what is happening. So we are not actually asserting anything, we are just looking at what is happening in the browser. Okay, let me quickly create my other test case for dog category on the same lines. All right, so I have created this test case file for dog category. Okay, so I have created two similar test cases. One, I am launching URL, and I'm also using the same fixture over here. This is one exactly same fixture over here, and then I have this test case where I launch this URL, and then I find and click this link for this particular product. Now let me run this test case, and to exclusively run these test cases, I will give them a mark at mark dot selenium underscore example. I'll give mark to all the test cases in both the files, that means 4 test cases, and I'll also add this mark in pytest.ini like we did in previous lecture. So we are so far so good over here. Let's do one more thing, and now we will understand two important things, conftest.py and session scope. Okay, so let's create a file named conftest.py at root level. So the important thing is I'm creating it at root level, so it is common to all the test cases for directory under which it is residing and all the directories beneath it at whatever level, and its name is conftest.py. Okay, and what I'll do, I'll copy it and comment it over here and paste it over here. Similarly, what I'll do, I'll comment this portion over here, right? So whatever is my common code, I'm moving it to conftest.py, and let me mark the scope as session. All right, and everything remains same, and so I have moved this to commonplace, and note that I'm not importing this conftest.py, and still I'm not changing any of my code. I'm still able to access Chrome underscore browser in the same way. So the element which this fixture, which is at commonplace, accessible to all the test case file, which this fixture is returning, is accessible across all the test cases. And finally, let's run the test case and understand the importance of scope session. So in our last lecture, we learned about scope module and the default scope function, and we also talked about class scope. In function, which was default scope, every time we will expect browser to open and close and open and close. In module, only one time when the test case file starts and ends. What will happen in session? Let's see. Let's run the test case. So it opens browser, and then it clicks on link. It doesn't close the browser at all, and in the same browser it opens the URL mentioned in other test case and performs the test cases. So effectively, what has happened with session scope is that with scope as session, the level has become package level. So time this package starts executing, the fixture is executed once, and whatever is our setup or teardown operation, they are executed only once at package level. And so this session is really important, especially when we are executing UI test cases, UI automation test cases. So that was all about this lecture. And with the help of this lecture, we learned about conftest.py, which helped to reduce our code at other level and also gave us more flexibility. The other, what we learned is scope session, which helped us to maintain browser session and execute test cases within that browser session. And that was all about this lecture. Let's meet in next lecture. Friends, I hope I was able to help you through this lecture. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to stay tuned and have more such videos. And don't forget to visit my website qamilestone.com, which talks about more such YouTube series, wonderful posts, and my Udemy courses. Thanks for now.